In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys another way to get historical data from DukaScopy. In the previous video, I showed you how to get it from the chart, from the various brokers. This is a software package that we use to get the historical data from DukaScopy, and it gives us much more historical data than is available on the chart. The first thing that we're going to do when we go into the historical data app, which is an online tool, is we're going to select the asset that we're going to use. Now, as you can see from the drop-down menu, we have many to choose from. We've got quite a few in the Forex, we've got some commodities, cryptocurrencies, as well as indexes. As we did in the previous video, we are going to work with the Euro USD, and here you can choose the format that you want it in. As we are using Expert Advisor Studio, we are going to select the JSON files. If you remember from the last video, these were the files that were generated when we ran the script on our chart. But here, all we need to do is just select it from the drop-down menu on the format option. And then all we do is click on load data. Now, as you can see, it is fetching data. Basically, what it's doing is it's requesting the data from the servers at DukaScopy. And once the software has fetched all of the data, all we need to do from there is simply click on the file. And from there, it goes into our default file location. Even though we're only going to be generating strategies on H1 in this course, we are still going to download all of the timeframes. And from there, we are going to put them into our Expert Advisor Studio. So all the files have now been downloaded. And from here, we're going to put them into our generator to create these strategies. Now, the great thing about this historical data app is that if you look at the bars that we are getting, there's 200,000 on M1, 200,000 on M5, and 200,000 on M15. Over 170,000 on M30, 85,000 on H1, around 22,000 on H4, and almost 4,300 on D1. This is a huge amount of historical data, and this is great when it comes to creating strategies in Expert Advisor Studio. The more bars we have, the more data we have to test the strategies on, and the better will be the results that we get. So from here, all we need to do is go back to our Expert Advisor Studio app. From there, we're going to go to data, the same as we did before. And what we're going to do is the same as we did with Forex Time. We are going to select all of the JSON files for all the time frames, and then we just drag it into our drop zone. Once again, they're being imported and uploaded, as you can see. Of course, it will take a little bit longer than it did with Forex Time because there is so much more data that we are importing, but it still only takes a few seconds to do it. And there it is complete. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.